Ask any young person in the United States, like these students at George Mason University in Virginia, how many friends they have on Facebook, and the answer will probably go something like this.
I've never actually like stopped and looked at it, probably somewhere between like 350 and 400, I don't know.
I would definitely be on Facebook all the time, like, wow, she's here, he's there.
Yeah, I am a heavy user. I rely a lot on it. I find myself checking it multiple times a day.
Researchers at Utah Valley University in Orem, Utah, wanted to see if all that time watching people on Facebook affected how users saw not themselves, but others. They asked 425 undergraduates if other people have better and happier lives. Then they surveyed those students on their use of Facebook, looking at how long they had been Facebook users or how many hours a week they spent following Facebook friends. They found the students who were more involved with Facebook were more likely to think other people's lives were happier and better. This was especially true among students who included more strangers on their Facebook accounts. Psychologist Todd Cashton studies happiness and well-being at George Mason University and has read the Utah findings.
They're hearing all these great things happening from other people and feeling that they're making a downward comparison to themselves, such that they're viewing themselves as, my life is as interesting or as satisfying as other people's lives look like.
The authors of the Utah study say the results may be due to a psychological effect called correspondence bias. That's when we make judgments about someone based on their disposition or personality while ignoring their actual life circumstances. In the case of Facebook use, it's easy to assume Facebook friends are always as happy as they appear on their profiles because they are not posting negative attributes or events, only positive ones. These students say they had similar feelings about what they saw on Facebook during high school, but that in college, they are more aware of the effect it has on them.
I give people the impression that my life is perfect and there's nothing wrong with it when there is so much, so it's really false. It's like someone else completely with my face.
I'm aware that whatever people post on Facebook isn't necessarily like what their entire life is made of. I feel like people put on like a fake picture of themselves and try to make themselves look a lot better than they actually are in real life when they're online.
Psychologists say Facebook and other social media can be valuable tools to connect with people and the world. But that assurance does come with a warning.
Don't spend a lot of time just looking at other people's positive events. Share your own and see who are your true friends, who really cares for the things that happen to you.
Psychologists also say Facebook users can lessen the effects highlighted in the Utah study by focusing on their real friends on Facebook and not on the Facebook friends they may hardly even know. Mona Rabi, VOA News.
You said, how are you guys just chilling?